Korea's two main political parties have shown no sign of reaching a compromise on a bill to reform the country's two pension systems, leaving the future of that and other bills in doubt. The main opposition New Politics Alliance for Democracy wants to move forward with that bill, while the ruling Saenuri Party now says the two systems should be dealt with separately and the civil servant pension reforms passed first. Our Ji Myung has more on this ongoing tussle.
As debate over the pension bill continues, one party has gone on the defensive and the other is in offensive mode. On Wednesday, ruling Saenuri Party chief Kim Moo conveyed his discontent with critics who say the reform plan was drawn up hastily, adding that consensus was only reached after 4 months.
The civil servant pension reform bill was discussed by various interest groups and they settled some of their differences. We asked for cooperation from the opposition party to pass at least the civil servant pension reform bill, as agreed on May 2nd.
Meanwhile, the opposition criticized the ruling party for scrapping the original plan and the presidential office for meddling in parliamentary affairs.
President Park Geun-hye has blamed the National Assembly for not passing the civil servant pension reforms and emphasized that the National Pension Reform Plan will place a heavy burden on taxpayers. But there's no evidence for that. The president is just instigating conflict.
The party struck agreement earlier this month on a bill covering reforms to both systems, but never voted on it because of argument over a clause related to the national pension scheme. That part of the plan would increase the payout to 50% of a subscriber's pre-retirement income from the current 40%. The presidential office, however, rejected the plan, saying the 10% increase will come at a cost of 1.5 trillion U.S. dollars through 2080. Given the impasse, there is growing concern that lawmakers may put off voting on other bills, only to come up empty-handed at the end of the May session. Ji Myung, Arirang News.